The Obama phenomenon represents an incredible desire among the majority of people in the United States and really worldwide, because Obama inspired governments and peoples all over the world. So it represents the pent-up frustrations with the last 30, 40 years, with the neoliberal counter-revolution and the deep-seated sentiment and desire for change, for fundamental change, social, economic, political, cultural change. And so there was a groundswell in support of Obama representing those sentiments and those desires for change. And ruling groups, the bigwigs within the Democratic Party, on Wall Street and the big financial institutions and transnational corporations, the wealthy, said, whoa, we can't deal with a groundswell from below. We need to co-opt. We need to control the groundswell from below.
Tonight, an extraordinary conversation with three foreign policy giants. Former Secretary of State Henry Kissinger, former National Security Advisor Brent Scowcroft, and former National Security Advisor Zbigniew Brzezinski. I interviewed them in New York yesterday evening at an event organized by the Center for Strategic and International Studies. The conversation took place at the Rainbow Room, high above Rockefeller Center, here in New York.
The political awakening that is happening worldwide is a major challenge for America, because it means that the world is much more restless, it's stirring, it has aspirations which are not easily satisfied. And if America is to lead, it has to relate itself somehow to these new, lively, intense political aspirations which make our age so different from even the recent past.
But he can give a new impetus to American foreign policy, partly because the reception of him is so extraordinary around the world. I think his task will be to develop an overall strategy for America in this period, when really a new world order can be created. It's a great opportunity. It isn't just a crisis.
Are told by lines that stretched around schools and churches in numbers this nation has never seen, by people who waited 3 hours and 4 hours, many for the first time in their lives, because they believed that this time must be different, that their voices could be that difference.
I will promise you this, that if we have not gotten our troops out by the time I am president, it is the first thing I will do. I will get our troops home. We will bring an end to this war. You can take that to the bank.
When I promise that we are going to bring this war in Iraq to a close in 2009, I want the American people to understand that I opposed this war in 2002, 2003, 4, 5, 6, and 7, so you can have confidence that I about ending this war.
Iran, they spend 1/100th of what we spend on the military. Iran, Cuba, Venezuela, these countries are tiny compared to the Soviet Union. They don't pose a serious threat to us.
I think it's time for us to end the embargo on Cuba. And I think that we have to end it because if you think about what's happening internationally, our planet is shrinking. And our biggest foreign policy challenge, and it feeds into directly into the battle on terrorism, and it feeds into issues of trade and our economy, is how do we make sure that other countries, in developing nations, are providing sustenance for their people, human rights for their people, a basic structure of government for their people that is stable and secure so that they can be partners in a brighter future for the entire planet.
Close down Guantanamo, restore habeas corpus, say no to renditions, no to wireless wiretaps.
I have said repeatedly that I intend to close Guantanamo, and I will follow through on that. I've said repeatedly that America doesn't torture, and I'm going to make sure that we don't torture. Those are part and parcel of an effort to regain America's moral stature in the world.
And as president, I'm going to make it impossible for congressmen or lobbyists to slip pork barrel projects or corporate welfare into laws when no one's looking, because when I'm president, meetings where laws are written will be more open to the public, no more secrecy. That's a commitment I make to you as president. When there's a tax bill being debated in Congress, you will know the names of the corporations that would benefit and how much money they would get. And we will put every corporate tax break and every pork barrel project online for every American to see. You will know who asked for them, and you can decide whether your representative is actually representing you.
Our jobs are only solar panels and wind turbines and the fuel-efficient cars of tomorrow. Jobs that will help us end our dependence on foreign oil and they save the planet in the process.
Out old theory that says we should give more to billionaires and big corporations and hope that prosperity trickles down on everybody else. The last thing we can afford is four more years where no one in Washington is watching anyone on Wall Street, because politicians and lobbyists killed common sense regulations. Those are the theories that got us into this mess. They haven't worked, and it is time for change, and that's why I'm running for president of the United States of America. Bail out Wall Street banks. As president, I will ensure the financial rescue plan helps stop foreclosures and protects your money instead of enriching CEOs. And I'll put in place the common sense regulations that I've been calling for throughout this campaign so that Wall Street can never cause a crisis like this again. That's the change we need. It's been a long time coming, but tonight, because of what we did on this day, in this election, at this defining moment, change has come to America.
It is absolutely true that NAFTA was a mistake.
A senior member of the Obama campaign called the Canadian government within the last month to say that when Senator Obama talks about opting out of the free trade deal, the Canadian government shouldn't worry. The operative said it's just campaign rhetoric and don't take it seriously.
The Canadian government put out a statement indicating that this was just not true. So I don't know who the sources. It wasn't true.
Amid all of the denials, sources at the highest level of the Canadian government who first confirmed that a call was made, late this afternoon, reconfirmed that a call was made.
How in the world are we going to speak about democracy?